Welcome to Trading Nation. I'm Eric Chemie. Today, we're joined by Keith Parker. He's global equity strategist at Barclays. Now, Keith, you've got a really interesting research report out there, and you're talking about how top-heavy the market is right now, where just a few stocks are driving the entire movement of the market in a way that's much bigger than the past. So just kind of walk us through what's happening, what are the numbers, and how it's different from the past few years.
Sure. Thanks, Eric. At the end of May, we pointed out that the top 10 contributing stocks to the S&P return to that point was nearly 50%, and that's come back a little bit in the last week or so to about 40, where the average or the median historically was about 30%. And so you had, you know, the kind of the most top-heavy market since about 2009.
So is that basically saying, if I get this right, 10 stocks are moving X, and the other 490 stocks combined are moving about the same X, and those two groups together have about moved the equal amount? Is that basically what you're saying?
Yeah, the basic math at the end of May was 10 stocks contributed 4% to the S&P return. The other 490 stocks contributed the other 4%.
Wow. So, yeah, exactly. It makes you wonder. You think about an economy, an overall market, an entire index, and really, it's an index that's kind of doing nothing, but you had a few good companies in there. So how do you make sense of that? Like, how do you deal with traders and investors that, you know, it's like you have two really different trades happening at the same time?
Yeah, I think post the election, you had a surge in value stocks, and you're left with a decision as an investor. Do you buy the things that have moved so much and re-rated up, or do you buy the laggards? And, you know, growth was very cheap. Tech and healthcare were very cheap in November, December, and we'd like that catch-up trade. We switched our tune at the end of April, and I think you're left with a similar backdrop where do you buy the value catch-up story to a degree, or do you fade those stocks that had led the market? And we went with the latter.
And I don't know if you got a chance to maybe look at what, you know, the top 10 stocks were and maybe what weren't in the top 10, but was there anything that, if you had a chance to look at them, that was surprising to you, that like, oh, I'm surprised that this company's in the top 10 or this company's not? Did anything like that stand out?
Yeah, not to a degree. I mean, it was very much tech heavy with Facebook, Amazon, Google, Microsoft, and a few others did slip in there that were kind of surprising, like J&J and Philip Morris and Comcast. But overall, you know, I think the message is it's not unusual for 5 to 10 stocks to drive a significant part of the return, i.e. 30%, but to have so much through May, I think, was the outlier.
And obviously, because it's a market cap weighted index, my guess is a lot of these top 10 companies are among the 10 biggest companies anyway, right? Is that true? Because if they all move the same percentage amount, these guys are going to kind of move the index more. Does that math make sense?
Yeah, I think that math makes sense for the most part, unless you add, you know, a reasonably well-sized company having outsized, you know, right, 50 to 60% returns.
So then, you know, if I'm just, let's say, watching this segment right now, maybe a retail trader, right? I'm just trying to figure out, like, what do I do with this? What is the best advice you have for somebody out there? Is it, you know, you try to run an S&P, maybe an ETF, but you hedge out part of it, or you just pick your favorite 10 stocks and go against, you know, like, how do you work that if you don't want to just trade the market and own the market by itself?
Yeah, I think the theme number one was, do you buy the stuff that's worked already tremendously? And we advise to selectively buy some of the laggards in value, i.e. financials and industrials, and start moving out of a reducing exposure to, say, tech and discretionary, and we've seen that trade work out pretty nicely over the last couple weeks. And I think at the single stock level, the other theme that we've been talking to investors about is a lot of the fiscal upside and tax has been priced out of the market on a single stock basis, and so positioning for that potentially changing and shifting over the coming months and quarter.
And obviously, when you look at the chart that we had up, what we're comparing is the year-to-date performance of the 10 biggest stocks now, or the 10, you know, most powerful stocks now, relative to the year-end performance in the past years. So it kind of makes me wonder, and I don't know if this data is available, is where were we in those past years in May and in June? And did we see bigger spikes earlier in the year that might have settled out by the end of the year? You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, I think that's a good question. We didn't address that specifically in the chart, but I think the gist of the piece is simply that leadership changes. And so I think we were at that point at the end of May. And obviously, I think that a lot of those stocks have great investment value over the medium term, but just positioning was stretched, valuation re-rated tremendously, and we've seen a deserved pullback.
Keith, I think it's a really fascinating chart, a really fascinating story. I hope you guys sort of continually keep updating it, because it's really going to be interesting to see how the rest of the year plays out with that number, and do the leaders have that much power over the rest of the market. So I think it's really fascinating, fantastic, and thank you guys for doing it and coming on here to talk about it.
Thank you. Appreciate the time.
And thanks to everyone else for joining us here on Trading Nation. I'm Eric Chemie. We'll see you next time.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.